After meeting four times in the span of 5 years in the Stanley Cup playoffs, the Maple Leafs and Senators created a rivalry that was second to none in the National Hockey League. Battle of Ontario has produced some of the most memorable moments in Ottawa Senators history. And this week, we take a look back at the best and worst from the Battle of Ontario.
These two teams, the Ottawa Senators and the Toronto Maple Leafs, have created one of the best rivalries in the NHL. The Battle of Ontario has really heated up since the 2000 playoffs when they met for the first time in the postseason. Numerous events have occurred to enliven the series, so let's take a look at a few. Back in January of 2004, during a 7-1 Sens victory, Daniel Alfredsson broke his stick and mimicked throwing it into the stands. Just previous to that, Leafs captain Matt Sundin had been suspended for actually throwing his stick. Needless to say, Leafs fans didn't take too kindly to that.
Well, let's have a look at it here. Daniel Alfredsson will break a stick. Away he goes. Watch this. Oh. Talk about rubbing salt into the wound of the Maple Leaf.
Oh, that was pretty funny. I can't speak for Matt's, but you know, I think he probably would have got a chuckle out of it too after the big deal that was made out of when he threw his stick for Alfie to do that. I thought it was pretty funny.
Of course, Toronto fans have been clamoring for Alfie's head long before that.
Who's on the board.
Big goal for us. I think it was game five. I was able to hit him, to keep the puck in their end. And I think it was Julinen, the Finnish guy we got before the deadline. It fed me in front of the net, and Joseph was done. I had to wide open up to put it in.
Over the last few seasons, it seems Darcy Tucker has been involved in fewer incidents. But late in 2003, while Ottawa was up 4-1, Tucker tried to get at Chris Neal on the Sens bench. Pat Quinn, Leafs coach at the time, said Neal had spit on Tucker, a claim Tucker later said was not true. Still, as Neal said, old-time hockey.
Now it goes to the Ottawa bench to try and invite Chris Neal. Oh, a little bit of AHL. And Tucker goes to the bench and starts swinging at Chris Neal. Now all the Leafs pour to the Ottawa bench.
I have not seen this for a while.
And Chris Neal is pumping Darcy Tucker from the bench.
Neal's got to stop. They got to get Neal off right now if they can.
I just remember him coming at our bench and, basically trying to take a swing at me on the bench. So, it was pretty good melee out there. And, it's always intensifies the games. I live for that kind of stuff. And, it's great to... it gets everyone into the game, and everyone's emotional out there. And anytime you're playing the blue and white, it gets you revved up.
Toronto's success against Ottawa came during the first half of the decade. Over the last few years, Ottawa has been able to gain control of the series. Perhaps the turning point came early in 2005 when Brian McGrattan squared off with Ty Domi.
Now, McGrattan is a big guy. Domi, is not that big. And down, but he's got a big heart and he's tough. All watching. Oh, what a right hand that was by McGrattan. A quick right hand by McGrattan.
My first year in the league, and it's about this time in November, so end of October, mid November, somewhere in between there. And we're beating him pretty good, and I tried to find him before the game, but at the time I think he was picking and choosing his spots. And I kind of ran him, so he didn't have a choice. And, we squared off, and I tagged him with a pretty good one. I think it broke his nose or something. But that's probably one of my most memorable fights, too.
And who can forget the game when former Senator Zdeno Chara decided he'd had enough of Brian McCabe? At 6'2" and 220 pounds, McCabe is no small man. Yet Big Z tossed him around in what is called the ragdoll fight.
That's... not a wise move to get into it with the big man. He's pretty strong and throw a mean streak in there too at times. It's a dangerous combination. Z made him look pretty small. He's 6'6" or whatever, and then you throw skates on him, and he's got good balance and good strength. I was never seen anything like that before.
With all the highlights over the last 10 years, these provincial rivals have provided fans with many memorable moments. Recently, the Sens have been a little bit more competitive than the Leafs have been. Although on any given night, the fans and players of these two teams know that they'll be into the game. For Molson Senators Overtime, I'm Ben McCoy.